This is Robert Kraft, and I'm coming to you live on SNN Live, and we're at the Precious Metal Summit 2019 in Beaver Creek, Colorado. With me right now is Dr. Keith Barron from Aurania Resources. It's a publicly traded company. The symbol is ARU on the TSX Venture. Dr. Barron, welcome to SNN Live.
Thank you so much.
So for our audience, we'll start off with an overview of the company, and then we'll go from there.
Okay. Well, we are a junior explorer. We're working in Ecuador. In southeast Ecuador, down near the border with Peru. Very, very large land package, 208,000 hectares. It's more than 500,000 acres. It's essentially virgin ground. The only people who were on it before were the Spanish conquistadors almost 500 years ago. So it's been an interesting project. And, we'll talk about what we found.
Well, we last had Richard Spencer on a couple months ago at Sprott. So let's get an update. What's been going on at Aurania? And let's take it from there.
Well, lots of activity. We're now up to 20 epithermal gold-silver targets. That's an incredible number, really, for a junior company on one property. We have a high-grade lead-zinc-silver mantos replacement of limestone targets. We have a number of porphyry copper type targets, and we have a very, very interesting sedimentary hosted copper target. But our focus is gold. The project is called the Lost Cities because it started out, we were looking for two lost gold mines, actually, of the Spanish conquistadors that were mined from about 1560 up until 1605. They were abandoned, the jungle took over. We know there are other ones that have been found. The last one was found in 1982, not too far away. But that was the original premise. It got us into this humongous land package, and we've been exploring it in a very technically and scientifically sound manner.
You know, so like I said, we had Richard on previously. So what's your background? How did you come into all this?
Oh, gosh. I've been involved down in Ecuador since 1998. And in fact, on that trip, I met a university professor of history who told me about the Lost Cities. And we came up with that concept back then, decided we were going to start a company, started Aurelian Resources back in 2001. And the whole project took a bit of a left turn because I found golden outcrop in the very first month of working in Ecuador back in 2001. And that ended up culminating in 2006 with the Fruta del Norte discovery of 13.7 million ounces of gold, which was then sold on to Kinross for 1.2 billion Canadian. I was the largest shareholder, happily, and that's partly financing what we're doing now. But it was an incredible success. In fact, Lundin Gold owns it now, and they should be pouring gold in the next couple of weeks.
So then from what you can tell me, what are some of the company's value catalysts now for the rest of 2019 going into 2020?
Well, what we did before with the former company, Aurelian, was essentially turn a patch of pretty much worthless jungle into something worth $22 billion. And that's my modus operandi again. In fact, I think we can even do better than that because we now have multiple targets and double the land package that I had back then. It's a wonderful thing, and when you do make a discovery, my last company went up 10,000%, and certainly that's what I'm trying to do again. I own 54% of this company. I don't take a salary, and I'm very focused on it and very much aligned with the shareholders.
And where can our audience go and find more information?
Well, you can go to our website, aurania.com. That's spelled A-U-R-A-N-I-A.com. You can find my contact there, and if anybody's got any questions for me, just fire me an email.
My name is Robert Kraft, and I'm coming to you live on SNN Live. We're at the Precious Metal Summit 2019 in Beaver Creek, Colorado. With me again has been Dr. Keith Barron from Aurania Resources, publicly traded company. The symbol is ARU on the TSX Venture. Dr. Barron, it was a pleasure. Thank you.
Pleasure's all mine. Thank you.